Hey guys, just a quick update before we start and get into the video. I started editing it and very quickly noticed that the audio from the first episode only,
just the first one,
is really messed up. Like, not the Ganesh, but our audio is messed up.
Yeah, our talking audio.
Yeah.
And the reason for this,
we think, like, it's obvious,
is some instant karma, because Sabina says something quite inappropriate during this video. So if you want to see what Sabina says, it's quite hilarious. So try not to get offended, because as we know, this is a divine play. And part of divine plays is comedy.
Yeah.
Because from the wrong point of view, what she says could be seen as quite offensive to some. But of course, we know she's ignorant in the ways of words and expression. It's hilarious. So you're going to want to check
really
it out.
It's really embarrassing. Make sure you watch
the whole video, because you don't want to miss it.
So anyways, just to say that the audio is bad in this one, but in the other ones, it's all good again. So thank you.
Instant karma.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha, world raisers. Sabina and Roger here. It's time to learn about Ganesh. And we're going to start with Bal Ganesh, another animated movie. We do know a little bit about Ganesh, Roger, of course, more than me. But we want to know everything. So let's go. What is that?
Yeah.
Oh, is that his mouse?
Yeah, the
rat's a mouse. Oh, this is so sweetly done. Do we know how old this is?
No. Oh, no idea.
Ooh! I love that everybody's dancing.
Oh, the moonwalk.
Nice. I didn't know that booty shape was spiritual.
Here we go.
Oh god, he's wearing shoes, Roger. Like little
sandals. Yeah. Nice. Oh, there's a deity.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Who's that?
Oh, he couldn't open the book, but then he just bowed. Nirvignam Guru Me Deva. Sarvakaryeshu
Sarvada. Our story begins at the highest peak of the Himalayan range, Mount Kailash. Here lives Ganesha's father, Lord Shiv Shankar, and his mother, Parvati, along with Lord Shiva's most trusted companions, Nandi and his formidable army. And here begins the story of our darling little Bal Ganesh.
Wow!
Right. On Kailash. Yeah, that's Nandi.
The bull he's riding?
Parvati summoned Nandi, Lord Shiva's most trusted companion, and said to him,
Nandi, I'm just going into the palace to bathe. Do not let anyone into the palace until I give you further instructions.
Oh. Hmm.
As you wish, Mother.
Oh, that can only be Shiva. Sure is.
Greetings, Bholenath.
Let me pass, Nandi. I need to enter the palace.
Forgive me, my lord, but Mother Parvati has forbidden me from allowing anyone into the palace.
Don't be foolish. That instruction is for other people. You know that I am her lawful husband. Let me pass.
Yeah.
Oh, the music is so good.
There's another deity back there.
Oh yeah.
Who is that?
Beautiful tempos. So nicely done.
Parvati?
She's gonna be mad.
How did you manage to enter? Did Nandi stop you?
My dear, he's my trusted devotee. He wouldn't have the courage to try and stop me.
But I had told him to stand guard outside. He should not have disobeyed my instructions in this manner, my lord.
But Parvati, I'm your husband. What's the point in stopping me?
What you're saying is right, my lord. But for Nandi to disregard my orders so blatantly is unacceptable.
Don't be angry, my dear. You must forgive him. You know, he's a little dull in the head.
Oh, blaming him now.
It's his best companion.
No. What Nandi has done is not right. But what could he have done anyway? He loves his master. He wouldn't dare try and stop him entering his own house. I need someone who's intelligent, brave and strong, and will obey my orders without exception. I shall have to create this person myself.
So beautifully done. That's an unusual birth.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I just heard Sadhguru talking about it, so...
Divine
fruit. We knew this was coming.
Mom?
Oh, he's so cute.
Yeah, look at you. Music is so good.
Listen, he shall have to be extremely cautious.
Oh.
He could be hiding anywhere. Keep a straight watch out for him. He will pop out of nowhere all of a sudden. No way.
Mischievous, right. Just like little Krishna.
Yeah, I start seeing similarities.
Come.
There's no angels.
Ganesh, my son?
Yes, mother.
Dear Ganesh.
What is it, mother?
Listen, my son. It's time for my bath and I'm going inside to bathe. I want you to stand by the door, and until I give you instructions, you must not let anyone enter.
As you wish, mother. I shall not let anyone enter the house. You can have your bath in peace.
You won't start playing and forget what I said, right?
No, mother. Don't you worry at all. Huh? A stick? This will be good.
Yeah.
No. Forgive me, my lord, but I cannot allow you to enter.
My dear boy, who are you, by the way? And why do you prevent me from entering the palace?
I am Gauri's son, Ganesh.
Surprise!
And I am following my mother's strict orders. She has told me that, unless she tells me, I am not to allow anyone to enter the house.
Gauri's son? Then those instructions are not applicable for me. Because I am Gauri's husband, Shiv Shankar.
Huh?
Now step aside and let me pass.
Certainly not. Unless I receive orders from my mother, I cannot let anyone pass through.
Don't be adamant, my dear boy. Move out of the way.
That is not possible.
Look, you have no idea how angry I can get. Move out of the way. Or the consequences won't be good.
No matter what the consequences, you see, the sun may rise in the west, the moon may change its direction, but I will follow my dharma and not move from here.
Foolish boy!
Stay calm. Stay calm, my lord. He's just a little boy. Let me try and make him understand the situation.
Oh, no. If he still doesn't understand, then forcefully remove him.
Ganesh,
my boy, you haven't experienced the wrath of my master.
Don't try to frighten me. If you have the guts, then move me from here.
Not try and provoke me, boy.
You're nothing but a coward.
Is that what you think? Then let's see you fight me.
Huh?
Don't mess with Ganesh.
Run!
He broke all my bones.
Commander, immediately take your men along with you and go and teach that boy a lesson.
As you command, my lord.
No,
Let's go.
I haven't heard of these three.
There he is.
Yeah, no idea who those are. Well,
that is some parity. Oh, God, so good. Whoa,
Brahma.
Beautiful, yeah.
Absolute disaster. Lord Shankar has been blinded by his wrath and is causing calamity. Instead of trying to make little Ganesh understand with love, he has sent an army of soldiers to fight and defeat him.
It's true.
I shall certainly have to intervene.
Oh. Okay. That's beautiful.
Stop! What is this foolishness? One harmless little boy versus so many seasoned soldiers? Go away! Ganesh, my boy, you two should not be so very stubborn.
It isn't me, but father who's being stubborn.
You must obey your father, my child. Now move out of the way.
If I obey my father's orders, then what about my mother's orders, Lord Brahma? And what my mother tells me to do, I will never ever disobey.
Do not be stubborn. You should respect your elders. Now step aside from the door.
My mother holds the most important place in my heart. I will not move.
I shall have to use other tactics to get him to move. Or else, if Lord Shankar loses his temper, there will be disaster. Look here, my son. If you listen to me, I shall reward you handsomely.
Are you trying to pacify me by tempting me with a reward? That doesn't suit you, Lord Brahma.
Don't try and teach me. Step aside, or else.
No,
Brahma's so now you're
trying
to threaten
angry.
Me, but I'm not going to be afraid of you.
I shall have to use force to get him under control.
Oh.
You will have to be punished.
What happened with the love? looks like Hanuman's
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh.
Using the Brahmastra on this child won't be wise.
Huh?
The Astra. I think it's like a super powerful weapon.
Red eyes.
What is that?
Whoa. He's dancing now.
Terrible disaster is about to take place.
What do you mean, my lord?
Holy smokes.
Why do you seem upset? I hope all is well.
Wow.
My dear, Lord Shankar is at the peak of his anger, and he is dancing the dance of death.
Shiv Shankar is dancing the dance of death? Oh no, then there is certainly going to be a terrible calamity.
Indeed, we will have to go to Mount Kailash immediately to calm him down.
My lord,
wow.
I too would like to go with you. That way, I will get to meet my sister Parvati.
I think she's Lakshmi. Yeah,
they're sisters. I don't know.
Lakshmi, maybe. Oh no! Whoa!
There we go. I didn't expect that they actually show it like that.
That was sudden.
No!
Oh no. She's kind
of... My husband has killed my beloved son.
Devastated.
Ganesh!
That's horrible. In a way, like...
Bad Shiva.
Oh, Ganesh.
Who's that?
Yeah, the middle one? I don't know.
What is this you have done, my lord? Consumed with anger, you killed your own son? And all your pantheon of gods stood by without intervening and watched him commit this crime? None of you felt pity for this innocent child? Was it so important to your ego to prove your mettle against a mere child? And gather all the gods to witness it? speak up. Haven't you got anything to say? Has your anger been quenched by taking the life of a young, innocent boy? If it hasn't, then go ahead and kill me as well. I want my son back, alive. You will have to bring him back to life, my lord. Or else I too shall give up my life right here and now.
Do you realize what you are saying, Parvati?
I am only seeking justice. My son was innocent. He was merely following my orders.
Forgive me, my dear, but that is impossible.
Then it is impossible for me too to stay alive. If my son is not brought back to life this very instant, then I too shall sacrifice my life.
Consumed with anger, you took the life of your own son, Bholenath. Now you shall have to comply with Parvati's demands and bring the young Ganesh back to life at once.
Yes.
If not, the fire of her anger will destroy the entire universe.
What?
Actually, Parvati's persistence is not without good reason.
In anger, you have committed a very improper deed. And this is the only way to make up for it, Bholenath.
You must abandon your ego and concede to the wish of Goddess Parvati, Bholenath.
That is not possible. The head that has been once separated from the body by my weapon cannot be joined back to the body again.
Aye.
Then there is only one way out. You will have to find the head of another child that has not been struck by your weapon and attach it to the body of Bal Ganesh.
Because of the weapon.
Do not waste any more time thinking about it. Give the orders to your men at once.
Go. Go and bring back the head of another child whose face points towards the north and whose mother is sleeping with her back towards him. Now leave.
As you command, my lord.
Do not waste time. If we delay any further, he will never come back to life.
Sorry, let's stop here for part number one. Yes.
That was intense.
So.
So yeah, a little cliffhanger. Now, so Ganesha's life is in the balance.
In the balance?
Yeah, it's kind of, it's limbo, right? So they're going to,
yeah.
Right? So they need to go get another head. And I think we all know where the story's going. But still, what a great, great animation so far. Loving it.
Yeah. I'm just digesting. Okay. So they're living on Kailash, which of course they do. And then Parvati makes his own baby. And we heard Sadhguru say, yes, because Shiva is impotent. Why are you laughing?
I never heard him say that.
He could. The semen is useless. Shiva's semen does not produce a child. That's what we just watched.
No, you got that wrong.
What? Why?
It's not impotent and useless. It's just that
that's the wrong word.
It's too powerful for a normal human. So, which is why, like, you can't impregnate a human because it's god semen, right?
So yeah, but Parvati is not a human.
Yeah, I know. So that's kind of confusing.
What? Oh, impotent is the wrong word, isn't it? That. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Yeah, I get it
now. You just gonna have to probably cut that part out. Shiva is most definitely not impotent. He's like the god of all gods. So, totally wrong word. But Sakura was saying, as depending on the story, so as an Adiyogi or even Shiva manifesting as form as Shankar, he can't just go around impregnating women because it would kill them, right?
Okay, I get it now.
Right.
Yeah. I didn't mean that word. Yeah. I meant like it's impossible.
But anyway, so that's why you need to read the Hanuman Chalisa, because there's a story in there about...
About that. Okay. So she makes her own child.
Mm-hmm.
And then that child tries to follow her orders. Yeah. It's really interesting, that dilemma. Like,
mm-hmm.
am I following my mom's orders and now here's my dad?
Mm-hmm.
And aren't they equal? And then do I have to choose now? Because yeah, if I follow my dad's wish, then I go against my mom's, and
mm-hmm.
this is very interesting.
Yeah, well, like what happens? So his dharma, obviously, so created by his mother, so the devotion, he said, is she's the first in my heart, so I gotta follow her orders, you know, even when, you know, dad shows up. But the thing is, he can't really have a connection with Shiva at that point, other than knowing that, okay, well, he's Parvati's husband, so technically my dad, but I haven't even met him yet, right? And Parvati said, let no one enter. So it could have been handled, like in my mind, like explaining a little better, just, hey, dad, why don't we go for a walk or sit down and let's get to know each other. Let's talk about your adventures and let me know your story, and you can teach me some things, and let's just wait for mom, right? You know, but instead it's like, no.
So that the story can happen.
But it's so the history of Ganesh can happen, and why he has the Ganapati head.
Yeah.
So, yeah, great. And the animation is fantastic. I love it. Because we watched the Hanuman trailers.
Oh, yeah.
And that was like... mind-blowing. So this is right up there, a little
beautiful
earlier version.
And the music, fantastic. So, yes, thank you so much for joining. And let's see you on part number two.
Part number two coming up.